Hi kids, and welcome to VeggieTales! I'm Bob the Tomato, and I'm Larry the Cucumber! And today we're gonna perform a ritual! A terrible, awful ritual! Bob! Bob! Yeah, Larry? We can't do that! This is a Christian show! It's VeggieTales! But I wanna perform a ritual! We can't do that, Bob! What type of ritual, anyway? An evil ritual! Bob! No! Have you gone mad? Larry, I really think we need to do a ritual! No, I think we need to do a Christian-themed Western story!
A Christian-themed Western story?
Yeah, Bob! A Christian-themed Western story! A Blesstern!
I really think we need to do a ritual, Larry!
A Blesstern, Bob! A ritual! A Blesstern, Bob!
Could you give us just a second?
So me and Larry decided that what you really need is
a Blesstern. No ritual.
Yeah, that's right, Bob. No ritual. Kids or adults, here is Bob and Larry's Blesstern. Roll film!
Oh, Larry, how lame.
Once upon a time, in the Old West, there was a wealthy rancher.
Hi, I'm Dad Asparagus, and I'm a wealthy rancher. I'm hiring a new farmhand to help me around the farm. There's a lot to do here, and I really could use some help. Oh look, here he comes now.
Hi, Dad!
Oh, hi, Bob, how are you?
I'm doing okay. And yourself?
I'm doing good. Fancy seeing you here.
Well, yeah, I'm the farmhand. A farmer hired me. Someone, nearby.
Wait, what?
Yeah, someone nearby hired me to be the farmhand. Isn't that cool?
I had no idea, Bob. You're the farmhand?
You're the farmer?
Wow, I didn't even realize I was hiring you.
I didn't even realize I'd be working for you. This is great.
Thank you, Larry!
You're welcome, Bob. I figured if we weren't going to do a ritual, I could at least throw you a bone within this Blesstern. You get to act with Dad Asparagus.
Haha, that makes me happy.
Oh, it makes me happy, too.
Ooh, Mr. Lunt, what are you doing here?
Hello. I am the other farmhand that this man hired.
There can only be one.
Oh, okay. Mr. Lunt, stick to the script. Oh, sorry.
Larry, why do you keep breaking character?
Excuse me?
This isn't the VeggieTales show. It's a teleplay. We normally do a lot better with these.
Oh, that's right. Sorry. Hello!
Hi, stranger. How are you?
I'm doing good. I heard that you were the new farmhand around these parts. I own the farm down the road. I was wondering if maybe you wanted to work for me. Well, I'm already working for, Dad over here.
Yeah, that's right. He's my farmhand. Sorry, Larry.
I'm not Larry. I'm Pete.
Oh, sorry, Pete.
That's alright. Would you at least like to hear my offer?
Well, I've already got a job, but I guess it wouldn't hurt for you to tell me.
Alright, so I would be giving you $15 in 30 minutes, so $30 an hour in total.
I'm gonna what? Dad over here is paying me $5 an hour, below minimum wage. Don't tell the police.
Oh, hey, what was that?
Nothing!
The garden ruler has been stolen!
Yeah, you better go check on that. Don't worry about, minimum wage stuff. I got your back, Dad.
Thank you, Bob.
Wow. $30 an hour, Pete?
That's right!
Wow. That's a lot of money. But, I've already made a commitment here to Dad, and I need to stick to that.
Oh, well, okay. If you change your mind, just let me know.
Right. You got it.
Bob was struggling. He really wanted the $30 an hour. He was only getting $5 with Dad, but he'd already made a commitment to Dad. Oi, bucket of bolts. What's he gonna do?
Gosh, I sure could be making a lot if I went and worked for Pete. But, Dad's, man, I shouldn't have made this commitment. But since I did, I gotta stick to it. It's what God would want.
Hello? Ah, Jimmy? No, I'm not Jimmy. I'm Maid Marian.
Huh?
I'm the maid. Dad hired me to be the maid around the house. Isn't that cool?
Jimmy? That doesn't make any sense. A maid's typically a woman, right?
Well, I guess that's one way to look at it.
I'm confused.
I'm a queen!
Jimmy, you're a man!
Oh, Bob, Don't you understand?
Well, I'm not trying to misgender you, Jimmy. If you really are a woman, then I respect that.
No, no. I am a man. I'm just a woman for now.
What do you mean?
I am a man. Jimmy Gourd. He, him. That's me. Jimmy Gourd. He, him.
Well, then why are you a maid?
Well, when I'm a maid, I'm a woman. But when I'm not a maid, I'm a man.
Jimmy, that doesn't make any sense at all.
Oh, Bob. You don't have a very big imagination, do you?
I guess not.
Oh, let me put it this way. It's incredible where you can go in your imagination. Hitch a ride on a cloud and go sailing off into the blue. Ask a high-flying birdie to come with you on your vacation. There's a rainbow of beautiful colors waiting for you.
It's okay, Jimmy.
It's remarkable who you can meet in your imagination. You can swim with the fishies or go for a walk on the moon. Or make friends with a seal and engage him in deep conversation. Hey, Mr. Seal! While an owl with a saxophone plays you a rock and roll tune. You can see what you wanna see, be what you wanna be, feel what you're longing to feel. Just look in your mind, it's a place you can find where the things that you dream of seem real. It's astonishing what you can do in your imagination. There are so many things to go over and under and through. So Jimmy is pleased to extend you this kind invitation. To come visit our world that is simply too good to be true. La 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 la. Too good to be true. So Bob, why can't I just imagine I'm a maid for a little bit? You know? It's not official. I'm not actually a maid. I just want to pretend for a short period of time.
Well, okay, Jimmy. I guess.
Oh, good. Anyway, I'm gonna go make some pancakes. Goodbye!
Bye, Jimmy. Huh. Man, that doesn't solve my conundrum. Or maybe it does. I can just imagine I'm getting paid $30 an hour. Hey, wait a minute. That's a great idea. If I imagine I'm getting $30 an hour, I can spend my money as if I am getting $30 an hour. Why, that won't cause a financial crisis at all. On to the Country Stuff Mart.
So Bob ran down to the Country Stuff Mart.
Allow us to introduce ourselves, partner. We're neighbors and we saddled in down the street.
Saddled in?
Saddled in. I've never heard anyone use that terminology before. But hey, country, western, scallion folk, I like your hats.
Why, thank you, Bob. I like it too.
Yeah, me too.
I like our hats even more than any of you guys like them.
Oh, really? You wanna fight, pretty boy? Get him!
Ah!
Yeah, okay, well, I just landed a job where I'm getting paid $30 an hour.
Cha-ching! Oh, Bob, do you know what this means?
What does it mean?
It means you're so wealthy you can buy everything here. There's nothing off limits. Go check out our toaster oven aisle. Everything is available to you practically for free. $30 an hour, you can afford just about anything.
You really think so?
Oh, we don't just think so. We know so!
Yeah.
Well, okay, great. Wow.
So Bob went around buying the entire store. Heck, his shopping carts were full to the ceiling by the time he was done. Hi, Bucket of Bolts. That's right, he went to the Bucket of Bolts aisle and bought some Bucket of Bolts. I was actually there. I came in and couldn't wait to buy my weekly shipment, weekly purchase of a Bucket of Bolts. Here's what I said. Hi, Scallions.
Oh, hello, Paul.
You know what I'm here for.
You're the Bucket of Bolts guy.
Yeah, right. What aisle is it on again? I always forget.
Oh, well, that doesn't matter now. Bob just came in and bought all of the Bucket of Bolts.
What?
No! Bucket la, of holes.
La, 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 la. I'm like a kid from a candy shop. I got everything I need. All the food and all the money. It sure feels great to have greed.
Bob?
Oh, hi, Dad.
Bob, did you take that job with Larry?
Nope. I'm still working for you.
Then how did you afford all that stuff?
Well, I couldn't. I put it on a credit card, you see.
A credit card? We don't have credit cards. How did you afford all that stuff, Bob? If you haven't left me for Larry, how could you afford to buy the entire stuff mart?
Well, you see, I made counterfeit money.
You what?
I made counterfeit money. And I pretended that that counterfeit money was real money. And they took it. See, I used my imagination.
Bob, no!
What do you mean?
That's illegal! Oh, if the sheriff finds out, you're in trouble.
Oh, please. I am the sheriff.
You are not the sheriff. Not in this story.
I'm not?
No.
Oh, no. Well, no one's gonna tell him, right?
Telling me what?
Sheriff Scooter.
Hey! What do you not want to tell me?
What?
I say, what do you not want to tell me?
Nothing, actually. Okay, fine. Your mustache? It's shaved uneven today.
Hey! I need a mustache comb!
Well, that got rid of him.
Yeah, Bob, but only for now. You don't think he'll be back questioning you later?
I hope he's not back to question me later. Oh, man. Now would be a great time for a huge distraction. Something to prevent anyone from thinking about me and my, monetary fraud.
Well, what type of distraction do you mean? I could, break some pots and pans in the kitchen.
No, no, no. I mean like a town-wide distraction. Something that'll prevent Officer, Sheriff Scooter, sir, from thinking about me and the bad things I've
done. Well, when Sheriff Scooter wants to arrest someone, he normally gets them arrested pretty fast. You just better hope you're on good terms with him, or that he can forgive you.
Well, I did make a lot of counterfeit money, and I basically bought the stuff marked out. Once those scallions find out the money's counterfeit, I'm done for.
You mean those scallions?
they're coming!
Oh!
No, 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 it's not what you think!
Oh, it's exactly what we think! You're gonna go up the river!
Oh no! Jimmy, hide me! Hide me in your stomach folds!
No!
Dad, wrap me in your tie! Hide me away! Just like that time Charlie Pincher wrapped me up in his mustache.
Charlie Pincher didn't have a mustache.
There's clearly a lot you don't know about Charlie Pincher.
Huh?
Oh, Bob, when we get our hands on you, you're going down!
Down, down, down!
We're gonna tear you down!
That would be a great time for the distraction you were talking about.
Yeah, it really would. But what could possibly distract from... Somebody! Anybody! Quick!
Huh? Larry?
Pete! My name's Pete! And something very bad is happening!
What do you mean?
Oh, I looked out my backyard window and, well, I saw a cloud of smoke in the distance! And that can only mean one thing! What does it mean? What does it mean?
Oh, are you trying to distract us?
What's going on here?
No, listen! Alarming Albert's coming to town!
Alarming Albert?
Alarming Albert! Oh, you gotta hide me! You gotta hide your wife! You gotta hide your kids! You gotta hide your husbands! You gotta hide your moms and your dads and your sisters and your brothers and your uncles and your mothers! Alarming Albert will kill everyone!
How does he kill them?
With his alarm!
His what?
His alarm! Oh, we gotta do something! You all gotta let me in the house! Please! Please!
Sure, come on in. Scallions, you too. We'll hide away and talk about this.
Oi, I'll come as well.
Right, okay. We gotta figure out what's going on.
Pete, do you mind to explain? All right. Alarming Albert.
Oi, did you say Alarming Albert?
I did, Sheriff Scooter.
Oi, you don't have to explain any further. We gotta hide. No, this house won't be good enough. We gotta get barricades up. We gotta do something quick.
I really don't know what you're talking about.
Or me.
Yeah, can someone please...
We really just need...
Sanity? You want sanity? Well, there's no time for sanity! When Alarming Albert shows up, we're all gonna be dead! We have to work together!
Oi, just picture it in your mind. Pete, Larry, Bob, the Scallions, and Scooter, and Dad, and Jimmy, all hunkered away, waiting for this Alarming Albert to show up. Oi, who was Alarming Albert? Well, you're about to find out.
Rancher Dad, don't you have a tornado cellar for all the tornadoes we get around here?
Yeah, we do get a lot of tornadoes, and I do have a tornado basement. Do you think we can make it there in time?
I think we need to. It's the only place we'll be safe. Or at least, have the potential to be safe. Oh, I hope he doesn't get here too soon. I hope he doesn't... Oh no, it's him!
Why is he singing?
Oi, just wait!
It's over with! We're doomed!
Oi, the silly little story will be back after this silly little song! Oi, alright. Do you mind? Stop! Oi!
And now it's time for Silly Songs with Bob and Larry. The part of the show where Bob and Larry come out and sing a silly song.
Yippee-ki-yay!
Partner?
Partner, here we go. Let me tell you all a story about a girl named Lonesome Joan. When Joan was 3, she thought she'd try to tie her shoe alone. Her mama said, I'll show you how. She pushed her mom aside. I'll do it alone, said Lonesome Joan, and her laces stayed untied.
Oh, Lonesome Joan!
Lonesome Joan! Thought she had to do everything alone. She said, I don't need no help. I can do it by myself. Oh, Lonesome, Lonesome Joan.
Give it a go, Bob!
Well, she got a little older, thought she learned to read and write.
Uh-huh.
Her teacher tried to help her. Joan yelled, get out of my sight!
Oh, wow!
So she never learned to write her name or even read a book. And all alone, she never learned to swim or skate or count or cook.
Oh, Lonesome Joan! Lonesome Joan!
Thought she had to do everything alone.
Yeah! She said, I don't need no help. I can do it by myself.
Oh, Lonesome, Lonesome Joan.
Well, time went by and Joan grew old, as people sometimes will. When Joan was 81 years old, she met a girl named Lil. Lil said, Joan, it's just ridiculous, the things that you can't do. You're an 80-year-old woman, it's time you learn to tie your shoe.
Oh, Lonesome Joan, Lonesome Joan, you don't have to do everything alone. You can use a little help,
don't have to do it by yourself.
Oh, Lonesome, Lonesome Joan.
So Lil taught Joan to read and write, and tie her shoe and more. And Joan lived through the happy age of 134.
Oh, wow.
So be sure you learn the lesson from that old girl, Lonesome Joan. When you're trying for the first time, you don't have to try alone.
Oh, Lonesome Joan, Lonesome Joan, you don't have to do everything alone. You can use a little help, don't have to do it by yourself. Oh, Lonesome, Lonesome Joan. Oh, Lonesome, Lonesome Joan.
Oh, yeah!
Yippee-ki-yay!
Partner?
I don't understand. Well, you have to understand. Why is he scary?
I don't get it either. Somebody help me. I have confusion in my brain. Oh, I'm afraid for my life.
Oh, he's getting closer.
But what does it mean?
Let me explain.
Go for it.
Alarming Albert comes to town every week with his weekly emergency alarm and gives people heart attacks. Oh,
a mustache comb.
Wait, he gives people heart attacks?
Uh-huh, because his alarm is so jarring, so scary. And sometimes, well, every now and then, that alarm means something.
Like what?
It means a tornado's coming, or someone's gone missing, or worse.
What could be worse?
I don't know, but it means bad stuff, and sometimes it's just a test, which is equally annoying.
Well...
I'm in the house!
Okay, now I'm scared!
Hello! I'm Alarming Albert!
Ah! It's Alarming Albert! Run for the hills!
Wait, don't you...
He's speaking in code!
Well, I don't want to stick around to decipher it, Pete. Let's go!
It's too late!
There's no outrunning this!
Oh no! My home!
No! Pete! No! What about my $30 an hour?
You'll have to find it somewhere else.
Wait, huh? You were planning on leaving me to work for Pete? But you made a commitment, Bob.
Oh, Dad, I wasn't really gonna leave you. I was just pretending, imagining that I'd left you to get $30 an hour, and it was becoming so real in my mind. And, Scallions, that's why I went to Stuff Mart and bought everything, cause I...
I'm very well acquainted too, but matters not a matter. I understand the question.
Oh, my heart!
You're dead, how would I get my money?
I didn't even that carry fat money to play!
Yeah, Scallion 2, Scallion 1, Scallion 3, calm down! I will avenge Bob and Pete! Alarming Albert? I challenge you to a showdown. You're gonna pay. What do you say? I'll take that as a yes.
Jimmy, wait, no. With my last dying breath, I have to insist that you
Don't do this!
Yeah, Jimmy. It's not worth it. We're already gonna die.
Aye! That's it, lad! Fight him! Fight him! Better you than me! Aye!
Oh, Scooter.
Alright, Alarming Albert, you come to this town every week, sounding your alarm. Sometimes for a real emergency, and sometimes just for a test. We all know the conspiracies behind what you're doing. We all know that you're trying to make terrible things happen. We all know that these heart attacks are entirely intentional. It's all your fault, Alarming Albert, and you're gonna pay. I'm taking you down. You've killed your last vegetable.
That's all you have to say?
I just said a whole lot. Why can't you? The alarm! My heart!
I made Jimbo!
This has gone on long enough! Alarming Albert, why are you doing what you're doing? Why? Why? That's not an answer!
Ooh, a mustache?
Oh, Sheriff Scooter, you stay out of this! He killed my best friend Bob! And he killed Pete! And he killed Maid Jimmy! Why? Why? Ow!
Sometimes it takes an asparagus to fight an asparagus!
Why? Those shades look lovely on you! Why are you putting on those scary sunglasses?
That means it's battle time.
Aye.
Alarming Albert, I'm summoning God. God, I am a pastor. I love you. I worship you daily, and I need your help in this battle. Take down Alarming Albert. Give me Samson strength.
In this moment, all was forgotten. The counterfeit money, the betrayal, and the $30 an hour. Everything was forgotten. Dad forgot that Bob wanted to betray him. Pete, who was dying, forgot that Bob almost came to work for him. Bob, who was dying, forgot that he almost left Dad! And that he wanted to, at least. And the scallions forgot all about the counterfeit. In this moment, all that mattered was that Mike, Dad Asparagus, Rancher Dad himself, was going to take down Alarming Albert with the newfound strength from God above.
All right,
he said, with a smexy smile.
It's asparagus in time.
He then proceeded to asparagus all over the place. Boy, even on Alarming Albert. And when you asparagus on a man, it's over with.
By the power invested in me.
Rancher Dad body slammed Alarming Albert into the ground. The impact sent Pete and Farmhand Bob's hearts back into motion. They rose up from the ground.
Bob! Oh, I'm alive!
I have risen!
Alarming Albert groaned in pain.
Ha! You got him! You defeated Alarming Albert!
I did.
Wow! I love you!
I love you too.
Hey, hold up a second. Sorry, I won't interfere.
You already have interfered.
What do you mean?
Bob here was willing to work with me for $5 an hour, and you offered him $30 an hour to work for you. He almost left me to work for you. You almost ruined our friendship and our partnership.
Yeah, he makes a good point, Pete. Yeah, kinda tampered with what we had going. I'm sorry. I shouldn't have offered you a better life. I shouldn't have offered you better than what you had. You should have just been happy with your $5 an hour, and I shouldn't have tried to tamper with that. I'm so sorry. Please forgive me. Oh, I forgive you, Pete. Scallions?
Yes, Bob? Do you forgive me for, the counterfeit money?
Oh, I forgive you, all right. Yes, I can forgive and forget.
Yeah, most certainly.
Uh-huh. But that doesn't mean you're not gonna go to Sheriff Scooter's jail for a while.
Oi! What are you talking about? What happened?
Oh, Sheriff Scooter, I'm sorry. I counterfeited the money.
You did what?
Counterfeited the money. I hope you'll have mercy on me. I know I deserve to go to jail.
Oi! A mustache gourd!
Where?
That one that you're holding in your hands.
I'm sorry. This isn't for you. It's for, Aunt Ruth.
You mean you have a perfectly good mustache comb, but you're not going to give it to me?
No, I can't.
All right, you're going to be locked away for a long time on charges of not giving a police officer a mustache comb and for counterfeiting money and buying out the entire Stuff Mart. Where's all the stuff from the Stuff Mart so we can return it?
A funny story about that. I kind of parked it in my truck by the edge of a cliff. And let's just say,
Well, at least Rancher Dad's house is okay.
Why wouldn't it be?
Because I kind of put a lot of stuff in your house as well.
What do you mean you kind of put a lot of stuff in my house?
I think he means he kind of put a lot of stuff in your house.
Uh-oh.
Meanwhile, I was walking in a shopping basket. Huh?
What's that in the sky?
Uh-oh. Oh no! And that's how I met your mother. Oi.
Sorry, Rancher Dad.
When you get out of prison, you're gonna be working for me for a long time.
Mercy? Please? Compassion? Anything? You really would have been better off working for me. Way to go.
Wait, what about Jimmy?
Oh no! Jimmy! Maid Jimmy!
Oh, it's no point. It's useless. My heart won't start back up again. Look, I taught you a lesson about imagination. You can always imagine I'm still with you. Goodbye, Bob. Pete. Rancher Dad. Sheriff. Scooter.
Oh no, he didn't tell us why!
Too late! He's dead! Oh, Maid Jimmy! Why? Why? This is all your fault, Farmhand Bob!
My fault? This is all Rancher Dad's fault! For only giving me $5 an hour! Are you kidding me? This is all the Scallion's fault for being so petty about some counterfeit money.
No, it's Pete's fault! You're trying to lure Bob away!
No, I admit it! It's my fault! All my fault! I'm the one to blame! I couldn't help it! The alarm, it got stuck! It just wouldn't leave me alone!
What do you mean, alarming Albert? Explain yourself!
Oh, I agreed one time to spread the alarm because there was a tornado. And, well, agreeing that one time it would turn out I got stuck in a contract. A contract saying I had to spread the alarm weekly for an emergency test on Cubo. Oh, and now I have to go around town and around the world spreading the alarm to everyone. It's my job. I'm indentured through the contract that I didn't mean to sign.
How are you talking without the alarm going off right now?
Oh, because my job is done. The alarm went off and I won't have to do it again until tomorrow. And then I'll have to come back here next week.
Why do you have to come back here?
Don't you know? This is Cubo.
Huh?
That's the name of this town. The old western town of Cubo. And since it's the weekly emergency alarm that comes to Cubo, he'll have to come back next week. Oh, that's right. And I dread to think of the people out home.
Listen, you don't have to be this alarming, Albert. We're going to help you get free of your contract, and we're going to start off by singing Modern Major General with no alarm!
Is that possible? I haven't done that since 2003!
It is possible. We're going to help you, Alarming Albert. Right, Scooter?
Oi! Yes! Jail can wait! We're going to help you! Go ahead, from the top!
I am the very model of a Modern Major General of information, vegetable, animal, and mineral. I know the kings of England, and I quote the facts historical from Marathon to Waterloo in order categorical.
And so the man is vegetable, animal, and mineral. I am the very model of a Modern Major General. Oh, yes, I did it! And so the man is vegetable, animal, and mineral. I am the very model of a Modern Major General. One more time. And so the man is vegetable, animal, and mineral. I am the very model of a Modern Major General.
Now start from the top. You're doing so good! Don't stop! Don't stop!
Oh no! Run!
I'm way ahead of you, Bob!
Oi! I gotta run!
Wait for me, Farmhand Bob! Rancher Dad's right behind you!
I hear they're looking for wise men down in Egypt.
Been fun, gotta go!
Yeah, see ya!
I'll never be understood! Oh, I'll never be understood! Oh.
Oi! Somewhat unresolved, but the end.
That's where the story ends? That's our Blesstern?
That's the Blesstern! Look, I work with what you give me. That was the script.
But everything was unresolved. What happened to Farmhand Bob? And Rancher Dad? And Pete? Especially Pete. Pete was a handsome guy. Oh, was he handsome.
Why? No one knows. Oh, well.
Wow. Well, we're over here by QWERTY to talk about what we learned today. QWERTY? QWERTY? What was that? It's coming from inside QWERTY. Huh? Jimmy, why did you crawl inside QWERTY?
I'm hibernating for the winter.
What do you mean? Right. Well, in our story, we learned a lesson in loyalty. Was that the lesson? I think so. So, Farmhand Bob agreed to work for Rancher Dad for $5 an hour, and then Pete came along and offered him even more. But, well, he knew that wasn't right. But still, he wanted to go do it. Wait, Larry, I don't understand. You shouldn't take better opportunities if they come up? Well, not if you're committed. How did he commit? By agreeing to work for him. Why couldn't he have quit and gone to work for Pete? Wouldn't that have made more sense? I don't know, Bob. I just work with the lessons I'm given, just like Paul said. Either way, it's important to be loyal, but it's also important to pursue the best career option that you can. I don't understand. I think we learned more from the silly song than we did from the episode. And what about the whole thing with Alarming Albert? What did we learn there? We learned that you can't judge others. But Alarming Albert was killing people. But he didn't mean to. He couldn't help it. He'd been forced to do this.
Forced by what?
The contract he signed.
Huh. Sounds like a lesson in being careful on what contracts you sign.
Oh! Wait a minute! Jean-Claude! Philippe!
Oui, hello, Larry!
Hello, Larry the Cucumber!
What is it that you want?
That script that you gave me. That story? The Blesstern? It ended up being really smart!
Wait, this was a script from Jean-Claude and Philippe?
Oui, tomato! We wrote this script alone! Ho-ho!
Wow! You wrote this story?
Uh-huh! Oui, we did!
Wow! And there was an actual lesson?
Uh-huh! A lesson in being careful what contracts you signed. See? I see what you did there. We wanted you to be confused, no? One part you think the lesson is loyalty.
And in the other part, you think it is not judging others until you know the full story.
But in the end, it is just a lesson in being careful what contracts you sign. Ha ha!
Ha ha ha! Wow. We really could have used this one back in 2006.
Yeah, with the whole Cubo thing. Wait, you even worked that in. Cubo Town. Wow, you guys are clever. Oui, tomato. We come from France for a reason.
Yeah, people from France are normally pretty smart. Just look at Madame Blue.
She sure knows how to work a pyramid scheme. Or something like that.
Yeah, pyramid of veggies that she's married to. Nothing to do with money.
Okay. Well, at the end of the day, it all has to do with money.
That's right.
Did somebody say money?
Oh, my goodness. It's alternate dimension incubator, Mr. Izzer.
Bon appetit.
I'm an asparagus.
Okay, well, before we wrap this one up, wait, I just realized something.
What's that?
I don't laugh. You laugh. A sarcastic little laugh. You go, but I just tried to laugh and realized I don't laugh.
Yeah, you're very sad.
I forgot. Okay. Well, you know who isn't sad? Alarming Albert.
Well, I thought he was sad at the end of the story. He got run away from. We all runned away from him.
Yeah, but, well, he found true love.
What do you mean?
Well, turns out he was going down to Egypt. And Scallion 1 was also going to Egypt. So they met in Egypt and fell in love.
Wow, Scallion 1 and Alarming Albert? That sounds about right. Archibald and Scallion 1 have always kind of been a thing.
I can see it. I can see it.
Well, your point being, Larry?
Oh, Alarming Albert wrote a little song for Scallion 1. It goes something like this. Roll film!
Oh.
With matters mathematical, I also stand equations both for simple and